Welcome to ArtiosCAD Pro Tips, where we share our favorite did-you-know moments in ArtiosCAD and show you how to make the software work harder for you. Be sure to leave comments below with content you'd like to see and subscribe for notifications on the latest videos. For today's Pro Tip, we're going to talk about customizing your standards library using the resizable design templates that already exist within ArtiosCAD. Today, we're using ArtiosCAD version 20.0.1. However, any version should suffice. Within ArtiosCAD, we have a vast library of standard templates that we can use to create various designs. The Resizable Design Templates, or RDTs, is a continuously growing folder system filled with designs that you can use. However, they are coded by number and may not have the exact specifications that your company wishes to see in terms of layers, dimension layout, etc. So today, we're going to talk about being able to create your own catalog of standards using the ones that already exist with a different naming convention, potentially a different organization structure, and a few additional dimension and annotation options that we can play with. The first thing we're going to do is run the standard that we wish to modify. In this case, I'm going to grab my typical RSC, coded as 0201. We run it using any settings that we normally would to generate our design. From here, I'm going to check on my different formatting. I like my dimensions, though perhaps I need an additional layer for a coating-free area on my glue flap. Okay. This then becomes my new template for a new standard or resizable design that I can use. I'm going to save it to a folder on my computer called Server Lib. For standard edition users, the Server Lib is a shared location which allows all users on a network to share the same templates and designs, as well as defaults. Client lib is a user location, and for enterprise users, we'll use the shared location or user default projects. Saving to these locations, I can use any naming convention that I wish, so RSC would suffice, though I personally like to modify them and also add an RDT to my resizable design templates, so that I know which ones are standards as opposed to geometry macros or reports. From here, I'll go to my defaults and apply either shared or user defaults depending on who needs access. Additionally, location defaults are available for any enterprise users. I can right-click on the style catalog to create any new folders or right-click on any folder to create folders within them. In this case, however, I'm going to right-click on my folder that I've customized and add new data. I will call this a corrugated design as my naming convention suggests, and label it RSC as opposed to 0201, a number that may not mean enough to my users. I double-click on that, browse for and locate my RSC RDT. And now I have a new design available in my catalog. The next time I run a standard, I can go directly to my folder, my RSC, choose my parameters as we do, and now any additional settings I've created, namely my outside coding layer, exist within my new template. Thank you for watching. Be sure to leave comments on topics you'd like to see in future videos below, and don't forget to subscribe.